Come on, see, you can start. We are live now.
Okay. Hi all, good afternoon and welcome to the webinar. I am Ms. Mansi, General Manager at KTD Representations. Many of you must have spoken and met me before as well. So I would like to say thanks to all of those who have supported us till date, and I'm sure will be supporting us in future as well. We'll be updating by coming Saturday via our FB post, emailers and WhatsApp with our future webinar schedule, which will be held in the first week of May. So you won't miss our future presentations. Now it's explore to beauty of Sharjah and Russell Khema with our expertise DMC, Lebenswelt Hospitality. So let's begin with the presentation, and I'm going to hand it over to Mayur. Mayur, please.
Okay. Yeah. Hi everyone, my name is Mayur, and today we are exploring the beauty of Russell Khema and Sharjah. So in the last presentation we had seen Ajman, Fujairah and Umm Al Quwain. So apart in UAE, we are now covering what all sectors can be part of the seven emirates. So after this three, now we are coming up with these two sectors. So before that, just like our regular practice, I'll just share with you our updated website, I can say, where you can actually have the information of the particular country which we are representing handy when your client is coming or visiting you, so that you can give them the presentation. So this is our website which we have redeveloped recently, and you can see the tabs over here. So this one is the UAE tab. Just click on explore, and then this is the total overview of the tab of United Arab Emirates. You can see the little information, you can see the key facts, you will see when to go, you can find the proper map, then you have the key attractions mentioned in UAE. Apart from that, we have festival and events which goes across UAE, and also Dubai is the major attraction what we have added over here as well. The shopping tips as well are been included. The food and drink section has been updated over here, so you can find a one-stop shop for all your clients need over here. So after this, let's begin with the webinar, and we will now start off. I'll hand it over to Amit to start the presentation. Amit, over to you now.
Thank you, Mayur. Good afternoon, everybody. As we have and as Mayur had, Mansi had clearly spoken to you that with our first webinar, we had covered up Ajman, Fujairah and Umm Al Quwain in its part. So now today we are going to have a look at the attractions of Russell Khema and Sharjah as a part of our unexplored UAE. So let's begin up. This is our ATD website with all the DMCs across the world, and a short description of Lebenswelt Hospitality Dubai, wherein we cater to UAE as the destination under Lebenswelt Hospitality Dubai. Now let's begin up with the seven emirates. The seven emirates for UAE are Abu Dhabi, Ajman, Fujairah, Sharjah, Dubai, Russell Khema and Umm Al Quwain, out of which Umm Al Quwain, Fujairah and Ajman have been covered from our end in the last unexplored part one. This one is an unexplored part two, wherein we'll cover Russell Khema and Sharjah as an emirate. Now Russell Khema, basically the distance from Russell Khema to Dubai to Russell Khema is 112 kilometers, wherein you have public transports available at Alhambra Bus Depot, Union Bus Station, and which arrives in Russell Khema. The cost approximately is 25 AED per way, and it takes around 2 hours. The buses start from 8 AM to 9:30 PM. Every 1.5 hour is a transfer. Also, you can have your transfers booked from ground operations or operators where you book the ground. Russell Khema as a destination. As you know that Russell Khema is the northernmost tip of UAE, fourth largest emirate in UAE, known as an adventure emirate of UAE, also a boutique emirate due to its unique and natural landscapes. The eastern side is bordered with Oman, hence geographical surroundings are much like Oman. Russell Khema has its own airport, Russell Khema International Airport, which still arrives Air India Express flights from Calicut as well. Russell Khema tourism authorities are in talk with SpiceJet to start their operations from Delhi post coronavirus effect or pandemic, their talks might go ahead, and then subsequently they will also start the services from rest of the India. Basically, Russell Khaimah activities revolve around five natural assets that are their mountains, coast, desert, hot springs, and mangroves. Russell Khaimah, being on the northernmost tip of UAE, is cooler than 15 to 15 degrees than other Emirate cities. Also, the mountainous region of Russell Khaimahs are cooler by 10 to 15 degrees more than their city center. Best time to visit Russell Khaimah is between October to May, and it's booming up as a major market for MICE and wedding ceremonies across India. Now get to sightseeing. Basically, as we discussed with regards to their five natural assets, the sightseeing that we will cover are ranging from around fort to the mosque to museum to pearl farm, water sports, safaris, natural reserves, and Jabal Jais. 14 activities that we'll cover in this webinar. To begin with, we start off with the Dayat Fort. Basically, an 18th century fortification, highest hilltop in UAE. Was built in 1819, was the last bastion of local resistance to Britain. A great maritime treaty was signed in 1820, after which between the sheikhs and the British government. You need to climb 250 odd steps to reach the fort. Muhammad bin Salem Mosque. This is the largest surviving traditional mosque with no minarets. If you can see the mosque, building, it doesn't have any minarets over there. Dated late 19th century, recently been restored, and is a foil to the massive Ottoman inspiration. Non-Muslims are welcome outside prayer timings, dress moderately, and women should don a headscarf. Prior permission is required as it's an active praying mosque, so you have to take a prior permission before you visit this mosque. Russell Khaimah National Museum. It's known as early existing fort. Inside the Russell Khaimah old town close to Muhammad bin Salem Mosque was destroyed twice in 1620s and 1820 by British. Served as a residence for ruling families in 1920, later become a police headquarters to prison before finally converted to a national museum in 1987. This rich diversity of traditional architect today exhibits historical, anthropographical, and archaeological material of Russell Khaimah and insights of his history and tradition. Jazirat al-Hamra, English name of Rare Island, is a town in south of a city known for collection of abandoned houses, including a mosque widely believed to be haunted. Rulers of Zab tribe, who later rehoused in Abu Dhabi following the dispute with the ruler of Russell Khaimah. Originally a tidal island, by 1830, home to some 200 people, mostly pearl dwellers. Long Beach Campgrounds. Join for a day or two on entire weekend hang. Long Beach Campgrounds has all the amenities and recreational activities from beach yoga, sea aerobics, kite flying, kayaking, water park, obstacle courses, play beach volleyball, meet farm animals, and kids can fit them at petting zoo. Also have outdoor spas and saunas at this hotel resort. Suwadi Pearl Farm. First cultured pearl farm founded by Abdullah Al-Suwadi in 2005 and only one in UAE to provide locally sourced pearl to jewelers across the world. Action starts when with line drills underwater. After going through timeline of pearling history, take part in oyster opening experience. Guests can choose which one, any one of the handful oysters kept in aquarium, and hope to find precious pearl inside, which the guest can even take home if luckily they find anyone in it. Mystic Dhow Cruise. this 24 meter traditional boat named Mistrake is built with teak planks. The enjoy boat ride furnished with traditional wooden equipments and traditional music. Also can indulge in water sports on board like swimming, kayaking, snorkeling while you are on boat itself. Also enjoy an amazing sunset of Arabian Gulf with traditional music. Water sports activities. Almost all resorts have various water activities. Because being in the northernmost tip and mostly surrounded by a coastal line, all the resorts basically are on the waterfront and all have water sport activities like jet skiing, deep sea fishing, parasailing, donut ride, fly fishing, fly boarding, kayaking, paddle board, and mini board. Also can take sea rings. Now, this is one thing to remember that sea rings that operates from Dubai can also be taken when you come. You have to come to Dubai, take a sea rings from the Deira side or Jumeirah side, and which flies over the mountains of Ras Al Khaimah and also has its landing on a beach of Doubletree by Hilton property along the coastline. Al Jazeera Aviation Club. Now, flying is an everybody's mainstream activity or what you dream about that you should fly a plane or in your lifetime. So flying in a microlight plane is an experience in itself. Al Jazeera Club gives you an experience to see all what happens in a cockpit right beside the pilot with the flying experience on this aviation club. Desert Safari. Desert basically in Ras Al Khaimah is rich in iron. So it has a rich tricot orange reddish color with many green oases in the desert itself. The three main basic camps are the Pasat village, largest camp, can manage around 1,000 people, famous for wedding sangeet ceremonies on Arabian dunes. Badawin Oasis camp, only authenticated camp set very deep in desert, provides various experiences like overnight camping, dinner, safari, camel trekking, quad biking, sandboarding, belly dancing, and so on. Barbecue dinner includes is a live cooking experience in this camp. The third one basically is the dunes camp camping. The dunes gambling have lot of facilities like bar, overnight tents, viewpoints, children playground areas, and activities like dune bashing, camel riding, hina painting, quad biking, shisha, tanura, belly dance, etc. in this camp. Falcon show and archery. Falcon show and archery basically attractive sessions that you can do falconry on live, learn about them, take on your hand and even feed them. Some of another fun activity boards are provided at the venue where you have to rent the time you want to enjoy archery at the Nature Reserve Al Wadi.
Amit, sorry to interrupt. Can you please come again on the last slide? Because I guess there was some network interruption. So the last slide was not clear.
Okay, fine. I'll repeat up the falcon show and archery. Basically, you have a falcon show and archery in the desert as well in Ras Al Khaimah, wherein in a falconry, you can learn about the falcons, take them on your hand and even feed them. Archery is also another fun-loving activity to enjoy there. Archery and hitting boards are provided at the venue where you can rent them for the time period you need to do archery. Sorry. Nature Reserve Al Wadi. Enormous protected 1,235 acres of land area within Wadi Khalajin. There are wide array of natural friendly activities like archery, falconry, catch and release fishing, horse riding, camel caravan, or bunch and dive under stars. It's also home to the Ritz-Carlton resort, managed resort Al Wadi Desert in Ras Al Khaimah. Rock Acquisitional and Adventure Club. Horses have been an integral part of Arab heritage, as you all know. So you can enjoy horse treks over here, or just visit and discover abundance of bird, and can encounter which, even if you are lucky, you can encounter with shy wildcats or desert foxes in this area. Jabal Jais. Now the main attraction and the booming attraction of Ras Al Khaimah is the mountains of Jabal Jais. Basically, the peak is almost 1,934 meters above sea level and has many activities like hiking and biking trails, canoeing in Wadi Souka with the night camping, sunset picnics. You can have arrange sunset picnics over there. Viewing Deck Park, 1,300 meters above sea level, lit by solar energy, having 7 viewing decks with 10 binoculars. Jazz Sky Maze, that's for children, where you can the children can enjoy the jazz maze, maze shows or maze mountain by the guided trainers. Zipline tours, with 5 kilometer distance between platform to platform, zipline tour have this Jabal Jais have 7 platforms. Minimum weight restrictions on zipline is 40 kgs and maximum weight is 100 kgs. Jabal Jais flights, its longest flight in the world and is in the Guinness Book of Records, around 2.83 kilometers in a Superman position, with a speed of up to 120 to 150 kilometers. Also, you can get certified Guinness Book Records certified flyer certificate once you complete this flying experience. Jabal Jais tours. Jabal Jais tours are shuttle services between the city or the designated places in the city to mountains and hotels of stay. With regards to, as we discussed, MICE and wedding, you also have an Alhambra International Conference Center in Ras Al Khaimah, which can accommodate around 3,000 guests and at a time, with an area of around 4,500 square meters. Set on sandy shores with terrace area of around 1,400 square meters on Arabian Gulf. It's first of its kind on a beach, beachfront convention center, basically on the beach. Wedding sangeets can also be arranged till 4 a.m. here, where you can use the indoor as well as outdoor beach areas. Now, dress code and food and drinks in Ras Al Khaimah. Basically, dress code is a normal dress code with non-revealing clothes in the city. On beach areas, you can wear swimsuits. Food, abundant restaurant cities, and also hotels serve delicious foods. Majorly, all hotels have an all-inclusive package. That is the best example of Ras Al Khaimah basically being a resort destination. All the hotels are having an all-inclusive F&B packages that are on offer. With regards to the drinks, that is alcoholic drinks and non-alcoholic drinks. Non-alcoholic drinks are readily available. Alcoholic drinks, it's a very much a liberal emirate in terms of alcoholic drinks. There are few dry hotels, guests can buy and consume from street liquor shops and consume in rooms. Hotel have their share of bars and pubs. No permit is required for purchasing liquor in Ras Al Khaimah. During Ramadan month, also liquor shops are open, but the bars are closed till 6 p.m. So if you want to consume liquor, you can very well purchase it from the liquor shop, and at your hotel room, you can consume it. Ras Al Khaimah is so liberal that even in this period of a pandemic lockdown, also liquor shops are open and guests can buy their liquor in their shopping times. Now, 3-star hotels or hotels and stays in Ras Al Khaimah. Basically, they have 3-star hotels like City Max, 1-to-1 Mughal Suites, Jannah Resorts and Villas, Ras Al Khaimah Hotel, etc. 4-star hotel comprises of DoubleTree by Hilton, Bin Majid Beach Resort, The Cove Rotana, Smart Lane, Bin Majid Beach Resort, etc. 5-star hotels have Waldorf Astoria, Ritz-Carlton Ras Al Khaimah, Al Wadi Desert, the Alhambra Residence and Village, etc. Mayur, hello.
Samet.
Yes, Mayur, do you have any questions with regards to Ras Al Khaimah that have been talked up?
Yes, there are some questions which are come up for Russell Khaimah. So should we take it in between right now?
Yeah, we will take up Russell Khaimah questions in between so that then we can continue with Sharjah.
Okay, not a problem. So Amit, there is one question from Mr. Vipul that what is the difference of sightseeing in Russell Khaimah and Dubai? So should we consider Russell Khaimah for sightseeing, or is it more difficult? Logistic wise over there.
See, logistic wise, there is no difficulty in Russell Khaimah as well as Dubai. Now, as you look at all the Emirates, basically each Emirate has its own distinction. Like, for example, if you take Abu Dhabi, Abu Dhabi has its Yas Island, its Ferrari World, its Yas Water Park, the Emirates Palace. Likewise, in Dubai, you have the tallest building, Burj Khalifa, Aquaventure Water Park. Now you are coming up with Dubai 2020 Expo. Likewise, being Russell Khaimah, as we told, that the adventures capital of UAE, it has a lot of adventure sports like water sports activities and the mountain biking, zip lining. So all the activities, if you check, you won't find the zip lining or mountain biking basically in Dubai or Abu Dhabi that much. But Russell Khaimah is distinctly famous with these Jabal Jais mountains.
Okay, great. That means even logistic wise, it is not difficult for activities in Sharjah.
No. If you want to choose to stay in Dubai as well, you can go to Russell Khaimah and do one or two activities and come back to Dubai. But ideally, it is advisable that you stay in Russell Khaimah so you come to know with the other Emirate as well for a couple of days and enjoy the local activities and sightseeing in Russell Khaimah itself.
Okay. That's good. So how many days are suggested for Russell Khaimah ideally? If you're considering right now, we have given the whole presentation Russell Khaimah. So how many days are ideal to stay in Russell Khaimah?
Ideally, if you want to cover Russell Khaimah as a whole with all the 14 attractions that we have discussed up, it's 6 nights of accommodation is enough to cover up. But however, you can club it with Dubai with 2 nights Russell Khaimah, 4 nights Dubai, or you can reduce down Dubai to 3 nights because many of the people have been to Dubai basically and they are looking out something different in the close vicinity. So you can take 2 nights Dubai or 3 nights Dubai to just view Burj Khalifa because it's one of an attraction in Dubai.
Correct.
Even if they travel a couple of times as well, they do tend to go to Burj Khalifa. So Burj Khalifa like a thing, you can do it once over there and then you can shift up to 3 nights, 4 nights in Russell Khaimah to enjoy the activities in Russell Khaimah, which are very much different from Dubai.
Okay. Are there different activities that resort offers, the activities which resort would be offering?
Yeah, the resorts offers a lot of water activities that we have discussed. All the water activities are basically on the resorts itself. Because all the majorly 90% of the hotels are resort hotels and are on the beach only.
Okay. So almost Russell Khaimah a day trip. Yeah, as Amit has spoken, the day trip is possible for Russell Khaimah. So there's one question which is asked by Mr. Abhishek. So do you have any luxury resorts in Russell Khaimah? Which are isolated and safe as well, because I guess considering the future situation of COVID-19, so he's asking that are there some isolated and safe resorts at Russell Khaimah?
Yes, Russell Khaimah has majorly all the safe resorts itself only because most of the resorts are having their own beaches, the private beaches. Basically, there are Double D by Hilton is the best resort. Waldorf Astoria is there, which is the first Astoria property in UAE. Also, Russell Khaimah as of now has around 6,700 room keys. However, by 2022, might now extend to 2023, they are expecting it to be having the double of almost 13,000 room keys. And by 2025, they are expecting around 25,000 room keys to be built, wherein new projects are in pipeline or about to open.
Oh, okay. That's a great news for the future travel then. Ms. Patika has one question that we can travel from Dubai to Russell Khaimah by road as she understands that visa is one, right?
Yes, the visa is one. The United Arab Emirates visa is one. So whichever country you enter, whichever country or whichever city is basically Emirate you travel, the visa is one and the only one UAE visa.
Okay, and how much time does it take to travel from Dubai to Russell Khaimah?
It's around 1.5 hours to 2 hours.
Okay. Okay. So this okay. Are only there 5-star resorts which offer you water sports? Are there any other resorts as well? You know, and maybe 4-star resort somewhere so that you know the budget. It's a considerable budget, but they also want to explore a Sanchayama resort. So it is possible.
Yeah, it's possible. Double Tree by Hilton is there. Okay. As you mentioned in the previous slide, if you can just scroll back over, Double Tree by Hilton is there, Bin Majid Beach Resort is there, the Cove Rotana, Smartlink, Bin Majid Beach Resort, all are having their water sport activities and their own beaches.
Okay, okay. Great. So apart from the private transportation mode, there's public transportation mode as well, right? From Dubai.
Yes, yes. From Dubai Al Daira bus stop, you can actually take a public bus to Ras Al Khaimah as well.
Okay,
and it's very cheap, around 20 to 25 dirhams per
way. Okay. Great. So I guess we will continue with Sharjah now. If anyone has some more questions, please do keep posting, and we will take those questions again after we are completed with Sharjah presentation.
Okay, thank you. So now we move on to Sharjah, which is one of the nearest Emirates to Dubai in terms of the distance, which is just around 48 kilometers away, and there are almost 5 ways to go to Sharjah from Dubai. That is via a bus from Union Square bus station in Daira. Taxi, the cheapest mode to go to Sharjah is by bus, that just cost around 10 to 15 dirhams per way and takes approximately 1 hour of your journey. And the quickest way basically is by taxi, costing around 100 to 150 dirhams and around 35 to 40 minutes that you take. Also, Sharjah has its own airport, Sharjah International Airport, which is a home to the national carrier Air Arabia. Sharjah, being called the cultural capital of UAE, is the third largest emirate in UAE and third most populated city after Dubai and Abu Dhabi. Sharjah borders Dubai to the south, Ajman and Umm Al Quwain to the north, and Ras Al Khaimah to the east. Sharjah is basically a dry state, abiding to the culture of the states. Best time to visit Sharjah is between October and May. Being a dry state, I mean the sale and possession of alcohol is almost entirely forbidden in Sharjah. Only exception is that if you have a personal license, you can bring alcohol from other emirates and consume at your home or your hotel room. Coming up with the new terminal, which is Sharjah International Airport, is also coming up with a new terminal and lodges to cater more and more guests. Major attractions in Sharjah basically revolve around museums and their cultural activities. However, has its own share of adventure activities as well, mainly water activities on its coastline and Koh Phangan coastal border in its provincial area. So we will discuss about 12 sightseeings in Sharjah in this webinar. Now we come to the first of its heart of Sharjah, and the rain room. Basically, heart of Sharjah comprises of local souks and shopping malls and stalls in the city where you can buy local stuff from the stalls. Rain room, it's one of its kind of a rain room wherein you will find that you are walking under an actual rainwater without getting wet. Basically, 15 guests can enjoy the rain room at one time, wherein when you are walking, there are sensors which stops the water falling on you, and it's raining elsewhere in the room. Also, in the heart of Sharjah, there is also a 5-star hotel, Al Bayt Hotel, having around 42 villas rooms, replicating the 1960s Sharjah culture and the style of their living. Sharjah Art Museum, a leading art institute in Persian Gulf region, established under the Supreme Council member and the ruler of Sharjah during the third Sharjah International Art Biennale, has collection of modern and contemporary art by artists from UAE and other Middle East countries. Hosts temporary exhibitions and educational events with total floor of 111,000 square meters, with galleries over two floors. Also has a shroud of Makkah's first copy in one of its 8 galleries. Basically, this tours, educational tours, are for the schools and universities across UAE or the Middle East countries, wherein they can come and learn the cultural of the country or the Middle East regions. Melaya Archaeological Center, well-known archaeological site and a museum where you can see a documentary of culture and then head to the desert to cater the six rites on the dunes. See fossil rocks right in the center of the desert and then head to the camp for dinner. However, there are no shows in this camp. That's why the tour operators basically have dune bashing majorly done in Sharjah area. Even if you're taking the safari from Dubai, couple of the operators do dune bashing in Sharjah. But when using the camp, they come to the Dubai area where you can have all the activities in the camp like belly dancing, tanura show, because there are no shows in Sharjah camps. Diving in Kofangan or kayaking in Kalba. Absolute delight to dive and snorkeling in Kofangan, where you can see coral gardens and marine species including turtles, rays, shark, schools of neon strip fish. Also, a paddling trip to the mangroves in Kalba gives you an insight of the bird life, including endangered Arabian white-collared kingfisher bird, which is found over there. Al Khan Beach, Cornish area. This 600 meters of sand and dedicated swimming beach in the area of city, close to Sharjah Aquarium and Sharjah Maritime Museum. You can do a lot of water activities like kayaking, kite surfing, parasailing, banana boat rides, flyboarding, etc. Where you can enjoy over here. Also, there are change rooms, showers, and toilets. For small kids, you have playground areas and designated swimming area at this beach as well. Al Khalid Lagoon starts at the central souk, popularly known as the Blue Souk, with an early easy walk along the Al Burai Corniche. After approximately 2.5 kilometers, which Al Manza waterfront, visit Maraza Art Park after sunset. Enjoy shows of siphonic fountains spanning 220 meters wide. Golf and Shooting Club. This is also a new activity that has been started with the introduction of the Golf Club. Basically, wherein it has an at par 72 hole golf club, golf area, excess of 7,300 yards, and a fully flooded floodlit gold course, enabling play till late evening. Also, there is a shooting club as well, along with it, wherein you can enjoy shooting with rifle and pistols. Paintballing, tennis, basketball, outdoor pool, and can also be enjoyed in full day's time. So basically, you can come early in the morning in a day, enjoy the other activities, enjoy golf by evening, and then can return back as a day tour activity as well. Al Mundra's Water Park. Al Mundra's Mazar Water Park waterfront basically has the water park wherein it hosts events, concerts, festivals throughout the year. Also has water park for all ages with areas of greenery for relaxation and hosting events and activities along its path. Also has a 1000 parking lot as well, with including a free Wi-Fi in the public facilities areas. Al Hefaya Mountain Conservation Center, spread over 12 kilometers, is home to 30 native mountain and desert species. Gold cards to visitors and train guides to answer questions on Arabian wildlife. Don't miss nocturnal exhibits showcasing nighttime activities of desert creatures in this conservation center. Sharjah Desert Park. Much more to desert environment, so much so that it is worth coming early and spending the whole day. Rare native animals at Arabian Wildlife Center, geological botanical secrets, kids can pet and feed at children's farm in this Sharjah Desert Park. Kalba Bird of Prey Center. Using live demonstrations and display, the center introduces a host of native raptor species. The population, both resident and migratory, can also be seen. Watch raptors at work and see the birds up close to their habitat. Allur Mosque and Butterfly House, a home to the stunning butterfly house nested on Allur Island, home to the around dozen butterfly species, 150 to 200 individual butterflies fluttering at any given time, with a 3.5 kilometer long boardwalk through landscape gardens and light installations bring life at night. Now we come to the hotels in Sharjah. Basically, Sharjah also has abundant of 3-star, 4-star, 5-star hotels. 3-star hotels like Centro Sharjah by Rotana, Ibis Style Sharjah, City Max Sharjah, Noah Park, etc., which are been widely used in the Indian market. 4-star hotel comprises of Tulip Inn Al Khan Hotel, Koftran Hotel Sharjah, Alhambra Hotel, Four Points by Sheraton, etc. 5-star hotels also have Pullman property in Pullman Sharjah, Hilton property as a Hilton Sharjah, Al Faya Retreat, etc. Basically, this is about Sharjah. And Mayur, are you there?
Yes, Amit, I'm there.
So this is all about Sharjah, where basically it's all about the culture and museums and cultural activities. Basically, very only one part of the beach has water activities, and adventure sports are not basically mountain adventures are not there in Sharjah.
Okay.
So we can now go ahead with some questions and if they come up, Sharjah.
Amit, I guess hotel parts are done for you, Amit, this one?
Yes, hotel parts are done for me. I guess you have left the room for, with the network, I guess, for a second.
Okay. So, hello everyone. So, we'll be taking up the questions now for Sharjah. Before that, I would like to just bring one thing to the notice of you all, that this presentation and this webinar you can find at our YouTube channel on which is ATD Representations. As you can see on this slide, just type ATD Representations over here and you can find a link below in the description box where you can see bit.ly/the number and you can download the presentation from over there so that you know it can save on the email search, because I know a lot of webinars are happening these days. So you know, this is the solution that we have found out, where you can see the video as well as you can find the people download. Also, you can see the subscribe button on the right side, so please click the subscribe button and also on the bell icon so that you will be notified about the videos and the presentations that we upload. So it will be notified to you and you can then download it. You don't have to check every time that, you know, has it come or not, has it come on. So just subscribe and press the bell icon and you can have it at your end. So Amit, I'm done with this. We'll start off with the questions. So
yeah,
I'll just start off with the question. How is the Mr. Chetan wanted to know about nightlife in Ras Al Khaimah?
Nightlife basically is Ras Al Khaimah is very much abundant. There are restaurants, bars and pubs in Ras Al Khaimah as well, which goes around till night, wee hours of the night as well. On Thursdays, the nightclubs basically are open till 2 p.m. Rest of the days, they are open till 12 p.m.
Okay. And also Mr. Mahesh wants to know, is any metro available between Dubai to Sharjah?
No, as of now, the metro is not available. They are in process, but it's not completed yet.
Okay. Also, Mr. Keyur wants to know something about the, the 5-star luxury packages. He wants to know that are there any all-inclusive packages which resorts offer in 5-star? And also, what is the frequency of the public transport from Dubai to Ras Al Khaimah?
See, frequent transparency that we spoke about is that it starts from 8 o'clock till 9:30 p.m. and every 1.5 hour there is a bus that departs from Dubai to Ras Al Khaimah. That we have already discussed prior in the slide as well. It's mentioned in the PowerPoint presentation. All inclusive properties, yes, all inclusive properties come up with everything. With your activities, like you have a same resort hotel, a 5-star or a 4-star hotel, having your BB plan, your HB plan, your FB plan, your all-inclusive plan, wherein you can also has a set of activities that you can choose while booking. That out of 10, 3 out activities out of 10, or 4 activities out of 10, or 10 activities out of 10. The rates are dependent on how the plan you choose while making the booking.
Okay, that's great. Mr. Neeraj wants to know that you had spoken about the permit of carrying liquor to Sharjah. So how does one get that, and it is at what cost? Also, if we are doing a MICE movement over there, so does this permit stand valid?
See, basically, if you are doing a MICE movement over there, the permit won't stand valid. You will have to get it from the, you'll have to ask the hotel to make an arrangement, or you can buy it at the duty-free shops and take it at your hotel and do it at the time of event. Or then enter at a gala time event, basically. You cannot, the permit basically is not for majorly tourist people, but the hotel staff can assist you with the liquor component as well while doing MICE.
Okay. That's great. Mr. Tanaj wants to know that what is the cost of a rain room, and if we have group of 30 passengers, so how do we do it?
See, the rain room entry fee is around approximately 30 dirhams only. So it's basically cheap, because basically if you see, all the activities in Sharjah are very much cheap, because the government, Sharjah tourism government, basically spends 50% of it to every entry or every passenger on it, because of their culture, they want to promote their culture, and hence 50% of the expenses have been taken care by the government. Hence the rates for the activities in Sharjah are pretty cheap. Rain room entry is around 30 to 40 dirhams, and you can have if you are basically taking 30 passengers of a group, you can put them into two slots of 15-15 each.
Okay. Mr. Vipul is asking that if Russell Khaiman Sharjah has so much to offer, then why only promotions are done for Dubai and Abu Dhabi? Yes, Vipul, I guess now people will explore.
I guess then Mr. Vipul can start promoting Russell Khaiman Sharjah and other destinations more than Dubai and Abu Dhabi now.
Yes, definitely. Because I guess those are cheaper destinations, and also
very much in terms of accommodation, in terms of activities, they have lot to offer in terms of activities, the other Emirates. However, because of in less popularity among Indian nationals or Indian tourism, those are not been promoted over here. However, a lot of European people do tend to visit those islands, Emirates as well.
Okay, that's good. Mr. Debashish is asking that if we can club Dubai, Ras Al Khaimah and Sharjah in one itinerary, and if then, how many days and what will be the entry and exit point for the itinerary?
The entry and exit point for the itinerary can either be Dubai or Sharjah, anywhere depending on your flight. If you're taking Air Arabia, you can land into Sharjah as well, wherein if you want to stay in Dubai, you can come from Sharjah to Dubai. If you want to go to Ras Al Khaimah, you can go from Sharjah to Ras Al Khaimah as well. So that is the one thing. With regards to clubbing of the itinerary, basically it depends on how you want to promote it to your guest. Basically, if you want to promote mountain attractions or mountain excursions more, you can basically take them to Ras Al Khaimah with more nights, and with Dubai and Sharjah, comparatively less nights. If you want cultural activities for your guest, you can make them stay more in Sharjah, less in Ras Al Khaimah, and less in Dubai. And if you want to club all three on a uniform, maybe you can take 3 nights Dubai, 2 nights Ras Al Khaimah, 2 nights Sharjah, and cover some of the activities as a variety of activities in the trip.
Okay. That's it. We have a question come up on food now. Sab, does both the destinations have veg or Jain food option available?
Veg food is widely available. Jain food, basically, if there is a group, yes, we can arrange it. A couple of our hotel restaurants have Jain food availability. But as we say that those are on a la carte basis, where you can book the meal for them and they will be served at one go, and not like a buffet of Jain food. But veg food, yes, definitely available in both the destinations.
Okay. That's it. Also, there was one question that what is the approximate cost if the clients want to experience the flying, they want to do a flying experience. The flight one, which is in Ras Al Khaimah.
Al Jazeera flight, aviation
yes,
flight.
Aviation Club, correct.
Al Jazeera Aviation Club, basically the flight entry is around 200 dirhams per flight, and it's a 20-25 minutes flight.
Okay. That's great. So, any more questions coming up? So, guys, any more questions coming up? How far? Okay. So anyone has any more questions, please do post it in the chat box. And apart from that, also we will be emailing you all the answers to the questions which has been asked by you. So there will be a separate email in maybe 2, 3, or 4 slots depending on the number of questions. But yes, you will be receiving it, all the answers to the questions, whatever you have been, whatever have been asked in the chat box. So you don't have to remember, you know, what has been spoken or not. And definitely you will have it handy in your email. So, okay. So Kiran is asking that can we have exclusive Sharjah tour and for how many days?
Pardon? I'm not getting.
Kiran wants to know that can we have an exclusive Sharjah tour and for how many days?
Not able to hear you, Mayur.
Hello. Amit, am I audible now? Yes.
Yes.
So Kiran wants to know what we have. Can we have exclusive Sharjah tour and for how many days we should consider that?
Basically, yeah, you can have exclusive Sharjah tour like you have exclusive Dubai, exclusive Abu Dhabi. Basically, not Abu Dhabi is much more famous as an exclusive one. But yeah, you can have an exclusive Sharjah tour by around 4 nights of stay, and you can cover up majorly all the parts of Sharjah.
Okay, that's great. I guess, yeah. So, Amit, I guess questions would keep popping in, but we will end this session now. Because as we have said that some more questions can come up, we will be emailing all of them with the answers.
Sure.
We'll be now saying goodbye to all of you. I'll just turn on my video. So yes, as we are still getting some message that, you know, please share the presentation. And as we have said you that, yes, we will be sharing you the YouTube link by say tomorrow. By latest by Monday, so that you can see the proper webinar, and also you can have a PPT to download it from there. Already in my previous slide, I have shown that how you can get the PPT. So I have again come up with that slide. So just go to the YouTube channel of ATD Representations, click on subscribe, and in the description box below the particular video, you will find the download option. So that's it, guys, and we are finishing with this presentation for Sharjah and Ras Al Khaimah. And for the next part, we will keep you updated about the other webinars as well as the next part of UAE as well. So please do you know, sign in and do visit us again. Thank you so much, Amit. Over to you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for attending us and listening to the webinar. Thanks. Hope we have provided you some valuable information with regards to the destination of Sharjah at Ras Al Khaimah. Do join us for our next webinar as well. We will be covering up Dubai, Abu Dhabi, wherein some of the sightseeings and attractions in Dubai, Abu Dhabi, which are also very remotely known to the Indian people, have been covered in that. So stay tuned and keep on, we will keep you updated with that as well. Thank you very much. Thanks, Mayur.
Yes, thank you, Amit. Thank you all for attending this webinar. Thank you.